But without further ado, let's go into Leon B. I see he pulls up at the police station and saves Claire from the gas. Right, so as with last night, we've seen all the cutscenes.
I hope you made it here.
So we're not going to worry too much about cutscenes. Boom. There's some bolt cutters here somewhere. I'm sure there is. There they are. Right. Let's go down here, get the key. Plus anything else that we might need. Change into our RPD gear. Right.
That's exactly how I pictured breaking this in.
We are not going to use the deluxe weapon. Pretty sure that will give us a negative rank. Great start. You get the impression he might just kind of run off. Alright, I was going for an achievement there. That didn't work. Great start.
First day.
Alright, so I want to organize my items, please. There's a fuse in here.
Oh,
this gun is trash. Not gonna lie. This has been an absolutely dreadful start. I can't remember where the fuse is. Oh, I can get down here already. Okay. So maybe I'm not going crazy after all. There we go. Didn't realize I had to come down here straight away. Great start. Fantastic. Reminds me of the Brad Bird corridor. Brad Burton. It's not Brad Burton, is it? Brad Vickers. Jeez, what am I talking about? Burton. Barry's long estranged brother. Speaking of Brad Vickers, isn't that him on that poster right there? Sure, that was Brad.
Not exactly how I. Picture breaking this in.
Yeah, Brad. Oh, my God. That was a better way to get around there.
This is not how I imagined the first day.
Alright, go get the fuse. Right. So now let's go through. There's Mr. X. Why is there zombies in here already?
Something tells me he's not a cop.
Marvin's already turned. Where's my notes? Please scenario. Crown flame bird. There's a lot more zombies, it seems, in this scenario. That's quite worrying. Need spade key. Right, that's one. Let's go around this way.
What in the...
Oh my God. Fucking hell. This Leon scenario is brutal. Like, seriously. I think it's 9:15:07. Yep, there we go. Excellent. Oh, I'm gonna go around this way. This is what's going on, Napaz? Oh, what's the name of the first guy? I can't never remember. That's it, Ned. This one is Marvin. There we go. How you doing today, Napaz? Ooh, what's that for? It's for the Matilda. Did I leave the Matilda in the box? Possibly. Okay. Not to worry. Not a big problem since we've got those extra inventory slots off the bat. What do we want? 106, 109. Did you finish Death Stranding yesterday? I noticed that you wasn't playing it today. I didn't finish it. No, you bother. I did stop into one of your 7 Days to Die streams a while ago, actually. I didn't say anything at the time, but I didn't really understand what was going on. Is it kind of like a, am I right to say it's like you do like crafting and stuff in it? Nine millimeter. Yeah, they're 45. Yeah, okay, so let's do it good at the minute. In here, red herb. Yes, I know how to combine items. It doesn't look like we're going to be using much of the Matilda in this room because it doesn't look like the it's going to give us the ammo for it. Let's board that up. Zombie survival, every 7 days a horde attacks your base, otherwise you loot the world for ammo, food. Okay. Okay. So that's cool. I've never really played like many of like the open world survival games before.
What the?
Thank you. I completely missed that key with my Claire B playthrough. And I wondered why it was so difficult. Nah, it's not worth it, Napaz. Because the zombies take so much freaking... The zombies take so many freaking bullets in this game. Oh my god. Yeah, I found it wasn't worth trying to go for headshots. Instead, it's just trying to. It's best to try and just kind of wound them and run around them. I know that there is. I know that the game's got like a score, a live scoring system. And I think, it, from what I understand, it adapts like the difficulty based on how well you're doing. So, did you play this and review it when it first came out, Napaz? Oh, is it Mr. X in this corridor? No. He did all the routes. Okay. Don't want to use that if I can help it. But yeah, I made a massive mistake on when I did Claire B. I was kind of like, well, why isn't there a spade key? Because I had to like literally go around. So, it took me so long to go around everywhere. And then I realized a little bit after when I was uploading to YouTube and stuff that I just didn't go to the place where the frickin' thing was. So, that was a little bit annoying. All right, so detonate, we got that. Uh-oh. Please vacate the property, Mr. X. I don't know how he comes from this way, though, because, like, the freaking door is locked. Mr. X is a big cheater. He just teleports everywhere. Yes, I know game. Say I know and then I go and completely mess it up. I don't actually need that. Because I have my notes. So, unicorn statue is Child Scale's snake. He says... okay. Wow. Big fail. Oh, unless it's that one. There we go. Just picked the wrong one. That so I'm just gonna get that last one. Did I pick up the book? Yeah, I did. All right, cool. Mr. X was just an absolute nightmare in my first playthrough. He was just really, he's just so terrifying when you don't expect him. I didn't expect to be chased like throughout the whole entire game. Like he does. Oh, and I forgot about that. Surprised Mr. X wasn't there waiting for me. I didn't really want to tempt fate, but... He's in the frickin' library though, isn't he? Jeez. Should be the end of the spade key. Absolute tool. I guess I should really use the first aid spray. Or else I'm just going to be too slow. Right. Let's get me a magnum. Alright guys, I need a quick lavatory break. So, I'm just going to pause it there for 2 seconds. I will be right back. Okay. Right, so where is Mr. X? Is he up top? Or is he down below? Or is he none of the above? Oh, excuse me. Alright, so last one is Ram, Harp, Bird. Sure, last time when I was in here, Mr. X like actually came through and was here, so I was kind of expecting him to show up. Oh wow. Alright, we are... done here. Oh my goodness. The zombies are on a freaking mission tonight. Yeah, man, seriously, I can't, like, catch a break. No healing items at all, which is not good. Considering we got Birkin coming up. I shouldn't have played it so dangerously, really. I should have taken my time a little bit. What's nice here, though, is I'm going to actually find out, finally, what is in this freaking box. I'm assuming once you're in the sewers, you can actually make your way back to the police station, because you can't get this at this time in other scenarios. Oh, do I need to close that up, maybe? There we go. Long barrel lightning hawk. Alright, so. Nice. And. Need that anymore. Don't know how to get into there though. It's something we've not come across yet. If at all we can get in there. But yeah, this Birkin fight, I'm going to have to try and find one of the healing items straight off the bat. That's all I can really hope for here. Perhaps we're in big trouble. Most of the items are in the corners, so... And he does stagger a bit once you first jumps in at you. Alright.
Which won't work on this thing.
Plenty of defensive items, so. Take that. Take that. I need to run. Thank you, Leon. Wasn't half as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Somebody's watching.
Did deplete all my good ammo. Alright, let's get on out of here. And we'll go meet Ada. Ada Wong. Nothing else to pick up in here, is there? No. Now what I can't remember is whether or not, I know at one point there's dogs roaming in the garage, and I don't know if that's like right now. It might be. So I just need to pay attention. Got storage for days. Alright, we'll put that away for now. We'll take that. Yeah, that should do for now. Sweet. And we'll go to the garage.
I'm not done talking to you.
Probably quicker to follow Ada first, I'm not really sure, but I get the diamond key. To the firing range. And then we'll go follow Ada. I thought there was something else that was like relatively good in there, not just the roll of film. That was quite disappointing. This doesn't really help me, the parts from the Matilda though. I'm not using the Matilda at the minute, but shouldn't they can't grab you? That'd be cool. Power barrels should be a few in the generator room. Clock tower. I had to remember where, because with Claire, it's just in the storage room in the on the third floor, opposite the bell room. Through the kennels. So maybe I did take the long way around. Maybe I should have gone to the Ben side first. Open sesame. get the power on. Oh my goodness. Before I'd even had a chance to freaking aim the gun at him, he was already at me. That was madness. That made me jump. Right, we're out of there. Thank the Lord. Right, so I don't want that just yet. And don't want that. Gonna want the valve handle though. I know we use a valve handle, didn't we? Yeah. We did. Let me just combine all these so they're all together. Alright, gotta remember where to go. So I need to go up the stairs, open the... yeah, that's it, okay. Where I'm going. Up the fire escape. Through the corridor with the burning helicopter. Oh my god. Knock ain't going nowhere. Who's taking hits like that? So it's a lot easier now that I have the spade key this time around, unlike with Claire. Just can't go into the chief's room, can we? We can go down here. Key for this. I thought it was diamond key down here. Maybe I'm thinking of the original. I can't quite remember what's in there anyway. Alright, so... club key. We'll get that on the way back. What's that under there? Oh, is that somebody's leg? I guess it is. And get these herbs because the amount of hits we've been taking off these zombies. One of them's not dead. Alright. Wrecked. Oh, now Marvin. So Mr. X is behind me. He's the other side of that freaking door, isn't he? This is not going to end well. Oh my god, I was through the door, licker. I'm getting bullied. This is madness. Dead. That whole corridor was absolute madness. Like, the liquor and the zombies and everything. Where do I start from now, then? Back here. Oh, that's not too bad. So I've only got to get that again. Alright, got past him. Excellent. Use the key, Leon. Oh, he got me again as I'm walking through the freaking door. Oh my goodness, there's two of them. This is... God, I got completely the wrong freaking weapon selected. And guess who's right behind me? I have two lickers and Mr. X. Where did you come from? Alright. I just need to slow it down a bit, I think. I'm just trying to rush through and get through this too quickly. That's where I'm falling over at the minute. Get the cog. That could be bad, though. All right. And breathe. And breathe. Banks, thank you very much for the host. Appreciate it. How you doing tonight, my man? You good? That's good to hear. I've really been enjoying this game, actually, if I'm honest. Like I've just alluded to, though, I just feel like at the minute I'm trying to rush through too much at the minute. And I'm getting caught by anything and everything. Extra over there. You ain't nowhere near me. I'm where I need to be. Actually, this is sort of like my first playthrough of all the scenarios, and I played Claire A yesterday, like the other one for this, and I just ran it so quickly. I think I completed the whole playthrough blind in just under 2.5 hours last night of that scenario. So I'm kind of, in my mind, I'm thinking I should be like going really fast again, which is not necessarily the case. Oh my god. And I say, I'm just making stupid mistakes. I'm getting caught on stupid little things. Right, so. Want that. Don't need that anymore, don't need that anymore. Take out the electric parts. Alright. Healing's a big issue for me though at the minute. I've got like no healing at all. I got nothing. Don't grab me, don't grab me, don't grab me. Alright. Just gotta get past the dogs. Yeah, for sure. All right, we're almost at the RPD. Do this puzzle, and we're home and dry. Of all the weird creatures in my franchise, regular zombies always freak me out the most. Really? I think, for me personally, those weird things in Resident Evil 4, there were some really weird and wonderful characters and zombies in that, for sure. What's that? That's that. Yeah, Resi 4 had some real scary stuff in it. Can I not, like, loop that round? Clearly this puzzle is not my forte. Yeah, I mean, the zombies look amazing in this game. They are absolutely terrifying. When you, like, get close up to them, they're, like, biting you. They are absolutely terrifying. That goes around there, that goes around there, that goes around there. Could I go to there? That's gonna have to go across to there. Surely that's gotta go back down there, back down to there, and across to there. So is that like a conductive? Element? So that's there. Randomly did it. Always a good way to solve a puzzle, that is, isn't it? Being an avid puzzle person myself, I hate solving puzzles randomly. Come on, Exy.
Give me a break.
Whoa, punch and you miss. One thing I really wish that they hadn't taken out this game, and that's the they took out, like, the head stomping. The head stomping in, like, this game would be so beneficial. The amount of times I've, like, been grabbed by them, and you have to, like, waste ammo or just take the bite. yeah, excuse me. The head stomping would be really useful in this game. But yeah, the Resi 4 foes, man, like things popping out their heads and everything. Unfortunately, no. I was a bit weirded out with Resident Evil 4, like the direction that they took with it, because it was so, to me, it was so disjointed from, like the zombie thing. It was like completely different sort of game, and up until that point, Resident Evil's had always been zombies for me. So, come on, Ada, chop chop.
Road's out. Going through that gun shop looks like the only way.
Man, the first time I saw this the way this all plays out in here, absolutely, like, broke my heart. Excuse me.
What a mess.
Seeing, like, Kendo and Kendo's daughter, like, turning into a zombie. Probably should have saved that. I'm quite looking forward to playing the like the little side missions kind of thing. To find out a bit more about Kendo's story. What happened to his wife and stuff. Because I think I get the impression from that little cutscene he's had to kind of shoot or kill his wife. So I'm quite interested to see how that story plays out.
Based on what you've said, the sewer seems fitting.
All right, so.
Thanks. Can't imagine a real scientist being down here.
Next up, we got the croc escape thing.
Sewers are run by the city. How could they have a facility without the authorities knowing? Jesus! That an earthquake? What the hell?
Alright. Don't want to use the F8 sprays if I can help him. Like one bullet it gave me.
Again?
It's not too late to turn back.
No chance.
Ammo seems to be getting really hard to come by at the minute. Been this close before. Kaboom. Did I just get hit by that? I guess I did.
Chew on that. You overgrown son of a bitch.
Overgrown son of a bitch. Anytime today, Eddie.
Leon, up here.
What the hell was?
Just get up here.
Don't ask questions, Leon. Just do what the woman says.
Can't say I didn't warn you.
You said the virus turned people into monsters, not reptiles.
Fair point. I'm just impressed you made it in one piece.
Gee, thanks. somehow she kind of like walked in and then stepped right back out again.
So let me get this straight. Umbrella sells monsters like that to who? Our military? Somebody else's?
They don't sell the monsters. They sell the virus.
I just love Ada's character, the fact that she can be so casual in like the midst of a crisis.
And that is far more dangerous.
Nothing to, no, nothing salvage in here. Alright, so I can't remember how to... How do I use the thingy again? Oh, maybe I need to climb this first. There we go.
It's secret weapon time.
I love this section. This section's great. Proper, like, super spy stuff.
Candy from a baby.
Quite a good little tutorial area as well, I think. It tells you how to like use all the switches and everything. Which is quite nice. There's nothing really to pick up. Wide berth around these zombies. I really need to practice my aiming on these zombies. Not my aiming, my evading, sorry. I'm gonna shut the door. Really? Rip me. I thought that shut the door. Well, sucks to be me right now. Just kill me. I could have sworn that shut the door. No, I did have to do that. Okay. Alright, just kill me now. And we'll try this bit again. Cause that was awful. Please don't say I turned on assisted mode. Cause that would be awful. There we go. Alright. I gotta get in the incinerator, haven't I? That's right. Alright, get the incinerator, get the ID wristband. Then almost back at Leon's segment. We get to go down the sewers.
Bravo. Gonna burn me alive now. You'll never get your filthy hands on the G.
She wants the G.
I'm not the only one after it. You realize that. And you won't die alone.
Bitch knows what she's doing.
Visitor clearance confirmed. UID is authorized.
Where am I going?
Until
down here.
October 1st. Please return before this date.
Not gonna happen.
Yo, Subsonics. Welcome along to the stream, man. How did your Claire B run go tonight? Did you get one in? And how's that lovely bubble bath you was speaking of? Thanks for the host, my man. Appreciate it. Alright. So, but yeah, at the minute, everything is going... Okay. We are just entering into the sewers, so... I've got a million more miles to go. Before you head to the lab, hopefully we'll get everything sorted. 6 minutes off your run is impressive, my man. Congrats, well done. All right, so.
That's a pleasant smell.
The stinky sewer section. Leon B is going well, although I don't know, the zombies, man, have been brutal tonight. Literally, they're just unrelenting. I don't know. I'm trying to decide whether or not I'm just playing really badly and rushing through, or if the zombies really are like have really upped their game in this scenario. I know Resi 2 has got like the adaptive difficulty. Crap, that was freaking close. I know it's got the adaptive difficulty, so I don't know if like that's come into play at all, but yeah, I've been struggling. Oh, that's where that key is. Okay, so I've had a key for ages. I've had a key in all of my runs so far that I've not been able to use. I'm starting to think that is where I need to use it. That's the first time I picked up a combat knife. Interesting. And right down a little lower. Yeah, this is right. This seems right. Run. Thank you.
What the hell?
I hate them things with a passion.
Cable car.
All of the other things I said to you though before about the B scenario, I was actually a little bit wrong. It's not the B scenario where there's like massive differences. I think it's just you do it with Claire. If I remember. Because I'm hoping, actually, that I'm going to get all the way through this tonight and get to the end. I'll reload my save. Because I just it's the last fight that I was like really sort of referring to with the Claire run. I can't go back up there.
I'm coming, great.
But yeah, that's kind of like I felt it was a big homage to the original game. Well, it's in both Claire A and Claire B. Right. So, plugs. So all we need to do is get the plugs. To be honest, I think probably from this point onwards, though, this B is exactly the same as the A run. The only difference is obviously because you start in the other side of the police station with the B runs, the startings can, yeah, so it's all different. So you get the valve handle a lot sooner and a few other bits and pieces as well. But other than that, it's pretty much. Have I been down there? I don't remember going down here with one of the runs. That's the delivery receipt for that. Okay. But yeah, other than a few like routing differences, pretty much the same with the original game. It is pretty much identical. But the last fight on the Claire side of the thing is just freaking amazing. 212.8. Probably shouldn't have combined that straight away.
Jesus.
Alright, first things first, we'll go down this way. This is the worst way. I don't like coming down this way. Because of these weird ass freaking sewer monster things. So that's the key I was talking about, to that other room. I've picked that key up every playthrough so far and not known where the door is, and I think I just found the door. But I'm not going to worry about it in this playthrough too much. I just really want to get through this tonight if I can.
What the hell was that?
At least I've got defensive item. These things, man, are just the worst. Oh my god. Yeah, go on. Get attacked with a freaking zombie as well. Good job, Leon. Well done. Well, at least we're not poisoned. We're still in fine. It could be worse. Do the blue herb, though. Again, though, so I'm finding again with this run and Leon. I struggled for ammo with Leon before, and I'm struggling for ammo again now. King plug. That's not the king, that's the queen.
What the right. Hell?
That's what I want, so I'll take the legs out. And then flamethrower. There's a blue. That's what I wanted. Alright. That one. Put that there. Put the king plug here. So, I'll be a lot happier once I get, like, the other side of these freaking things again. But now that I've got a complete mixed herb thing, that does leave me slightly happier. I'm very concerned, though, about ammo for the working fire. Oh, come on, get a grip. There's one pops up here. Oh no. We're good. We're good. Alright. one more plug. And then it's Birkin Fight 2. Zombie there? Of course it is. Cue sewer monster. Can breathe a nice little sigh of relief now. We're through that bit. Gotta get past this dude here. Excellent. Some shotty shells. This dude sounds like he's having a fit. Cool, we are done with the sewers. With the exception of saving Ada, of course. That went pretty well. Actually, I'm going to grab this red herb as well. So we're going to have two full three herb heals. Excellent. Alright, what secondaries have we got? None. That's not so good. Alright, let me pull up my notes. So, we've got the scenario. On the left is Queen, Bishop, King. Queen. Bishop. King. Yeah, luckily it's pawns in the same place, and then it's knight, rook. Rook in the middle, knight turn. Luckily it's like there's only two different combinations. It's not like four different combinations for each Leon Claire variant. It's like one for the A scenarios, one for the B. Same with the labs as well, which is really helpful.
Almost there, Ada.
All right, so we're gonna do here. Let's take the Matilda and don't really want to use the flamethrower if I can help it. Nor do I want to take the Magnum. Okay, so let's grab our first save and go and save Ada Wong. Really worried about healing earlier on, but Things are starting to look up a bit. We got 3 full herb heals. That's crazy. That's everything. Cool. Alright.
It's still alive.
Let's go back in.
Now I got you.
I think he's in the firing line, though, is he? I was a bit worried there that he wasn't actually in the right place to get hit by that. Man, Leon, you need to get fit. Do some running. Get up.
Let's do this.
In case I need it. I don't think I needed it, but I didn't want to take the risk. What else did I forget? Oh, handgun bullets. Excellent. Right, let's go get Ada, and then it's just the lab. Ada! I don't think my soundboard's active. Sorry, subs. Is there anything in there? No.
The cable car will take us down to Nest. My wristband's our ticket to ride.
Nice. Where'd you get that?
Borrowed it. Anyway, we're almost there.
Borrowed it. I really want to know where that zombie... I noticed that that zombie, like, sat down there normally, just disappears. Really sort of interested as to where it goes. Can't either. Keep up. Well, they still have to wait for her. Alright. Oh, I am prepared. I really need to work out as well how to get back to the police station, because I'm pretty sure you can get back to the police station. Excuse me. I need an item box as well, just to configure some stuff. And the reason I say I'm pretty sure you can get back to the police station is because there's a door. When you get the medallions, there's a hydrant that you can like use this on. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure that there is a way to get back to the police station. Not really sure how, though. Welcome to Nest.
I wonder where the G virus is.
Leon, you're so gullible. Oh, hang on anymore. So, no good combining. Nope. How? I was facing the box. Seriously, game. Alright, so we got a knife. I don't need that anymore. Excuse me. I think I'll take that actually. Always good to have defensive items. There's that one zombie that's a douchebag in here. When you come out of the kitchen, he always grabs me. Like I said last night, I don't trust anything that you have genetically modified, Umbrella. Sorry. Oh, hey there. Thank you. Excellent. Right, let's head on into the lab. I think I'll take the flamethrower with me, actually. Just for the plants. Alright, so I'll stash that, flamethrower. Excellent. Stash that. Yeah, that should do us for now. Go. Alright, so we can quickly navigate the lab, hopefully. And we'll probably fail once again on the mixing puzzle like we did last night. I'm sure the mixing puzzle can be done in like one or two steps, but I just make an absolute hash of it. Here at the moment. So this should be, if I've written this down right, that one, and that's the hatch, and then the lab should be that one. That one and that one. That one. That one? Maybe. Oh, there's two of them. There we go. Okay.
Dispensing.
I love the way this planet is called Planet 43 as well. I found that quite amusing when I first read the documentation that goes along with this, like the planet and stuff. Alright. Use this.
Manual mode engaged. Adjust amount of solution to match cartridge capacity.
Okay. And so it begins. My failings. I've said this like every time I've played this like so far. Subs, you'll probably remember, right? Die Hard with a Vengeance. This reminds me of the puzzle when they're at the fountain and they gotta like do the elephants. Measure out the water for the elephants. You know what I mean, right? It's gonna give me the same result, isn't it? Why am I so bad at this puzzle? That's not enough. So I think now, swap these. Is that it? That should be it, right? Yes. Man, the Die Hard films when I was like younger was like up there for me with the Terminator films for sure. I love Bruce Willis and Samuel L. Jackson just ripping it up through New York City in a taxi. Excuse me. It was also helped by the fact that I had the game on the PlayStation as well. That game was quality. All right. Next question. Can I get through here without attracting or awaking any of the zombies or anything? No, I didn't want to do that. Beep beep. I think for me what made Die Hard with Vengeance that extra bit cool was that I had a light gun, I think it was the Predator, and you could use it with the PlayStation and the Sega Saturn at the time. And I think just having having those different games, because you had the third person shooter, then you had the first person shooter for Die Hard 2, and then just the driving one. It was like everything in one game. Such a classic game. Loved it. Jurassic Park robot.
Cooling complete.
Right, let's get the hell out of here. Could still be on for a sub 2:30 here. Yeah. I had two light guns actually for the PlayStation one. So I had the Predator one for a start, which you could use with the Sega Saturn as well. And then I also had the G-Con when Time Crisis was released on PlayStation as well. I think what was extra good about the G-Con was that you put a normal controller on the floor and you could use it as the foot pedal like you would in the arcade. That was quality. You missed the flamethrower? It was in the it was in all that area with the puzzle, the plug puzzle, that's it. Alright, while I'm here, this wants to be AWS for the next one, just to save myself a bit of time. We're not doing Mr. X now, aren't we? I got time for this plan, man.
Oh,
Alright. That's the last time I'll have to worry about Mr. X until the final confrontation, at least. How are we doing for time? Still under 2 hours at the minute. Just the final Birkin fight and Tyrant go. Oh, and the final. Yeah, the Ivy zombies are terrible, man. Big time.
Hopefully the GC was up here.
So I wonder how my luck will go with this Birkin fight, because with Leon, first time around with Leon, I managed to like smash it straight away. Both times I've done it with Claire, I've really struggled with this fight. I don't know why. Excuse me. Don't want the video. Blue herb isn't going to help me. At least we got lots of healing. That's one good thing though, right? I thought there was another tape there. Maybe not.
All right. Now back to Ada.
We've done our dirty work. I even think I've got like a lot of gunpowder. Alright, we don't need that anymore. Them heals though. That's pretty good. I'm happy with them. Alright, so we want the Lightning Hawk. And that's probably going to be about it. Oh no, okay, we got some more here. Put that in there. So that'll let us use the Matilda later on. So that's a backup. We'll probably need that for the final Tyrant fight, as well as a combat knife. So I really don't want to take my Samurai Edge out, because I think if I'm going for the S plus rank, which I may get, I don't know yet. I think I need. I probably won't be able to use the unlimited ammo weapons. All right, so I'm going to take a quick bathroom break. I'll be right back, and then we will finish up the scenario. Be about 2 minutes, guys. Thanks. Restart my local recording. All right, so what have I got? I did that gunpowder. I did save, didn't I? Did I save? I did save. So I don't want to save again, if I can. Yeah, let's take a combat knife, just as a secondary. Have I got any more secondaries? No. Alright. Let's go see what we can do. Against Big Billy Birkin. That's not a good start. this. Are you kidding me? And then I get trapped behind the fire as well. Jeez. God, why is it so hard to... There we go. Alright, now I'm in trouble. Magnum bullets, please. Help! Equip that. And ammo is a big issue. Maybe I should just try and throw him for him. There we go, we got him. Whew. All right. Billy Birkin is down. Let's pick up everything. I wouldn't really say GG stuff. I don't think that was a particularly great show of how to beat him. All right, so. Where's the other items? Over on the other side. Don't particularly want to use that if I can help it. At least there is like plenty of ammo and stuff in here, which is really nice. Let's get out of here. Let's go take on Tyrant.
Unauthorized
See you later, Ada. Ada! Alright. I think this looks so cool when you're coming down this elevator. So I've got two of them left. Cool. I've got four defensive items as well. Taking the shotgun, because the shotgun is all out of ammo. We can though take the Tilda if we stash. I think we need the wristband anymore, do we? See, this is where I get halfway down now and it'll say, you cannot go through this door, you need the wristband. Calling it now.
What the?
Mr. X show up here. Oh, I need the plugs. Crud. Combine. I forgot about the plugs. Let's stash the knife. And... Alright. Here we go. I've actually been told today, or found out today, that supposedly the knife is a really powerful weapon in this game. Apparently. And it's good against the bosses. Just means you need to get really close to the bosses. Really?
Oh,
Shoot. Any chance, get a little help here, Ada? Get wrecked.
5 minutes until detonation. You have arrived at the bottom level.
So informative. I know what there is to pick up here. Maybe there is nothing. All right, final fight time. This is going to be interesting. Yeah, come on, want some more? Watch the ending cutscene. But yeah.
We've gotta lose that car.
That's why I thought I'd let this play out for your subs. So now you haven't seen it. That last fight is really, really easy though. Insanely easy. I still don't know if that is scripted. See ya. Awkward.
No. We actually just met last night.
Yeah. That would have been one hell of a first date, though.
Yeah, you have no idea.
Look, he might be able to give us a ride.
What if it's not just the city?
Get Sherry out of here.
Come on.
Live another day by the grave.
So, is it over?
I don't know. But if it's not, we'll stop it. Whatever it takes.
Yeah, you're damn right we will.
As long as we stick together, we'll be fine. Come on.
T2 truck? Jack Nice and spills liquid nitrogen everywhere.
We can get a puppy.
Puppy.
And a parrot.
Parrot.
I always wanted pets, but my mom said they're too messy.
Next up on this boring Wednesday is a song to get your blood pumping.
What a class song it is. Alright, I'm going to skip this because we've seen the credits like ridiculous amount of times. We got an S plus! I think under 230 is S plus, so yeah. Awesome! Alright, what did we unlock this time? Because I'm sure we got lots of goodies to unlock. Model, Kendo and Emma, Adagator, Leon Casual and Sherry. School uniform infected version. Nice. Alright, so yeah. We got S pluses on the that scenario at least. We're gonna need to replay those two at some point as well to get those, and then maybe we'll try some hardcore. I just wanna see where my load game is for my Claire run from last night. Because I really want to show you this this boss fight subs, because it's pretty freaking awesome. How bizarre is that though? Look at how random is that, right? Look at the save time for the autosave of that one. 2341, 2341, 24 hours apart. Alright, if this is like the final fight, this is the fight I was early the Birkin fight again. Alright, we can do the Birkin fight again. I really want to show you this fight because it's such a cool fight. So yeah. Let's see if I can get to it. Deluxe weapon added. Do you know what? Yeah, sod it. Let's use the deluxe weapon. So let's can that. Yeah, because last night when I did finish this on the S plus, it gave me the infinite samurai edge, which I think is the infinite magnum. So yeah, that's what that is. All right, so let's try and all right. I got the Samurai Edge, the Albert model with was DLC when I bought the game, but for some reason I can't find any ammo for it. So I can't use it. Which is quite bizarre. Alright, so I gotta do this fight again. See if I can do it any better with Claire this time. It's not a magnum though, it's just like a pistol. I think it's just the Star's pistol. Well, that's disappointing. Alright guys, I'm going to have to go because my son has been sick. Sorry, I will show you that. If you want to see that fight subs, I really, really, go check it out. It's on my previous, yesterday's video. So if you go check my YouTube out, you'll see today's video. It came out at 1 p.m. The Claire B complete run through. Skip towards the end and just watch the final fight against G4. It's class. Anyway guys, sorry, gonna have to cut it there. Thanks for watching. I've been Nock. You've been awesome. Bye-bye.